all of our OB providers' schedules have changed with this crisis in order to decrease the number of people who are in the hospital. We are trying to keep enough providers in clinic and in the hospital to deliver your babies. One of our OB providers who is on call in the hospital is going to be there for your delivery. So what that means is that it is likely you will not see your primary OB for your delivery, but rest assured you are in good hands. Absolutely, you will still be able to receive low intervention care. All of our physicians are able to perform unmedicated deliveries, and our labor and delivery nurses are amazing as well, and they provide exceptional support to our low intervention patients. We have all services available in the hospital that we had prior to this event. We have lactation consultants, we have anesthesiology, we have social work. Anything that we would have provided to you before this outbreak is still here for you. With respect to lactation, please remember that our labor and delivery nurses and our postpartum nurses have gone through many hours of training in order to be able to support lactation and breastfeeding. Skin to skin and rooming in are very, very important processes. And so we have not changed our processes for mothers who are not positive for the infection or who are not currently under investigation. If you are not positive and not under investigation, then you will still get to do skin to skin and room in with your baby. However, if mom is positive or under investigation, then we will have an in-depth discussion with mom regarding current recommendations. At this time, the CDC is recommending that consideration be given to separating mom and baby when the mother is positive for COVID-19. It's important to realize that information is coming in daily from countries that are currently in the midst of this crisis, and so our recommendations are also changing daily. We recognize that skin-to-skin is important for the mother-baby bonding process as well as for initiation of lactation and breastfeeding. It is an incredibly difficult decision to separate a mom and a baby, and that's why we are going to make these decisions individually with every mom and the physicians who are taking care of her and her baby. Our breastfeeding recommendations have not changed at all. Based on data from China and from across the globe, the coronavirus has not been isolated in breast milk. And so we still want every mom to consider breastfeeding, especially given the immune benefits of breast milk for the baby. Our recommendations have changed a little bit, however, with mothers who are positive for COVID-19. We would recommend that those moms strongly consider pumping for breast milk and then having an uninfected caregiver feed the baby the expressed breast milk rather than actual breastfeeding. If actual breastfeeding must occur in these patients, then mom needs to wear a mask and gloves while breastfeeding. And I also think this is an important time to just remind everyone that we recommend good hand hygiene in all situations, regardless of this virus, before handling babies. If mom chooses to have a doula or a birthing coach, then that will count as the one visitor. Mom can have a visitor with her on the postpartum unit as well. Now, again, going back to our COVID positive moms and our people under investigation, we will be having those discussions with mom when she is admitted for labor. And those will be individualized decisions based on each mother's situation, as far as whether or not we would allow a support person during delivery and postpartum. Yes, we absolutely are considering early discharge for many of our patients. The American College of OBGYN has recommended consideration of early discharge, and so we are following those guidelines. It is important to remember that we will only consider early discharge if mom and baby are both healthy and in good, stable condition. Safety comes first, and we would never put anyone at risk in order to discharge a mom and a baby faster than usual.